life for you.
The town of An Daingean is illegal and will have to come down. The erection of the sign at the weekend follows.
I've got nothing to say.
I saw this handsome sign up on the hill, perfectly in proportion. It was a work of art, as far as I'd be concerned. Anyway.
I just thought, it's a really good idea. It was a really good idea. I was really happy that it wasn't just another good idea that remained pub talk in a pub. Let's do this, it's a great idea. But I was seriously impressed that Darragh had the actual energy and motivation behind him to put a team together to do it.
If one had put an article in the Kerry Man, the Times, the Examiner, one couldn't have got as easy much exposure for several sheets of ply hanging on the hill as he got for his exhibition.
It was a stroke of genius. And I heard about it on the radio first, and I went into Dingle to see it. And when I went to see it, the eye was missing off it. But I stood out near the sports field, circling myself, and we looked up and we said, thanks be to God, somebody has an opinion.
I have to say, I actually think it's one of the best examples of community-based art that I've seen in London. It was the most spectacular way of getting an opinion across to a huge amount of people. I mean, that really is what art is about, communication, and I thought it was perfect.
It was a pity it was hijacked as a protest. I mean, it kind of took a life of its own. But as a protest, it was even better than the impact it would have had in what it was designed for as an installation in the art exhibition.
Because of the conflict between Dingle and An Daingean at present, everyone assumed it was just because of the Dingle thing.
Mm-hmm.
But there's more to it.
Well, she told him so good gap. An Daingean is a good job. She didn't hear any of your language. Daingean is a good. Han dengen har rett, men han tog så egeri. At man han tog også noe farlig. Ta dengen lille ikke noe farlig. Og hvis han dengen noe farlig, men han gifte ikke noe dengen. Men så dengen er hos ikke det.
And I have to say at this point that I would personally like to see the Irish name, whether it is bastardization of Daingean Cuis or not. I would prefer to see Daingean Cuis first on the sign, if Dingle had been painted.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, it was Dingle always, and Daingean Cuis was always the name, and I'd go along with that. But, having said that, I can see where the minister is coming from. And I agree with him 100% about proper names for places. Now, Dingle is a trade name. It's a name that's known worldwide. And, of course, the Dingle people, if they want to, should be allowed to call their town anything they like. But the minister said that. But as far as the department was concerned, the official name of the town was An Daingean.
Because of the fact that it's been known as Dingle for the last 600 years, an explanation as to why it's not called Dingle now, when Dingle has been used in the promotion of the town for the last 30, 40 years, and an immense amount of money in that promotion has been spent in giving Dingle high which it has all over the world.
Why should the name change to Dingle is only a bottle of smoke, like that? We all know Dingle as Dingle or An Daingean. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter to the locals, you know, but everyone that's outside of here, the place is known as Dingle. On every map in the world, you'll buy it, Dingle is on the map. But Dingle and An Daingean on every road sign between here and Tralee at least, anyway.
The only problem I had with it was when I saw the photograph, that the people standing in the photographs had bags over their heads. And I says, now there now is another problem. We have this problem that people, enough people, are not prepared to stand up and defend their opinion. And I mean, you were prepared to do that. But it's an awful pity that, you know, that there are more people, young people like you.
Do I think it should stay up? No. No, I think it was perfect. The timing of it was just perfect. The fact that it's gone means that it doesn't turn into something else. If it was to stay there, it would just be another sign on the landscape.
Good God, no, I think the sign has served this function.
No, I don't think it should. I don't think it ever meant to stay. It was just a statement. It wasn't good to stay for starters.
We were fishing actually the following night at about 12:30. And in the middle of the day, about 12 o'clock in the day, we were about 10 miles from Dingle. You know, and Jesus, we were in the wheelhouse, and Chris says to me, he said, Jesus, you see the sign inside? Like, he said, you could see it quite plain, back the bay, right back in the mountain, anyway, you could see it as plain as day.
What Darrell managed to do with this project was actually to really spectacularly get his opinion across to a huge amount of people without hurting anybody, without getting into anybody's way. And he also brought a huge amount of humour to the whole debate.
This is an Irish farm, this is outdoor, this is something that's not, it's got to hit you to make an impression, and it's not going to stay forever, it's gone. If you're lucky enough to be there to experience that, that's the one.
They come to this dear place, as dear can be. They come to sup from the investment cup. It's now dear for you and me. Concrete, tile and pavement grey replace the green, brown and yellow hue. It fills each precious acre where lazy beds once grew. Then the National Names Commission drives the final nail. Those place name clinicians would have our finger signs in braille. Will this cloak of anonymity filter out the dregs and dross and preserve some of our culture's grace, especially from us?